How should you price your home on the market? Hi everyone, it's Nick McLean, owner of the Nick McLean Real Estate Group, and I get this question all the time. What should I list my home for on the marketplace? And I'm also going to tell you why everyone is doing it wrong. See, there's four different types of values a home can have. It can have the tax assessed value. This is the value that the tax assessor puts on your home. Definitely don't want to use that one when it comes to pricing it for the marketplace. Number two is a computerized generated value. These are values generated by a computer algorithm using different factors. They'll look at homes that have sold in the area, your square footage, your beds, your baths, your tax success value, and some other particulars, and give you a value. These are typically within a 17% plus or minus range. So you could be 17% too high, which means you're going to sell for less than you deserve, and or you could price it too low and give it away. But it's a good ballpark to go with a computerized valuation. There's also an appraised value. This is an appraiser would go out there to your house for a refinance or for a purchase and verify a price. Or they would also look at past sales in the last 3 to 6 months and give you a value of your home, with some slight changes for quality, condition, beds, baths. This is usually used to verify a price. So it's not always the best price to use when you go to price your home on the marketplace, because when you price your home on the marketplace, you want to get the most money. You don't necessarily want to price it at what someone else got a few months ago. You want to price it so you can get the most money now. The fourth way is a broker can give you an opinion of value. So the broker is going to use the same approach as an appraiser, but they're going to maybe fine-tune it with their gut feeling, or even worse, try to guess what you want and then put it on the market there. But if you accidentally tell them that you're willing to take 400 and it's worth 500, what's the agent going to do? Stop you? I don't know. Not all agents will do that because they make money on commissions. So there's an agency problem here, where the person that you're asking for advice is the one that makes money when it sells. So the lower it goes, the more likely it's going to sell. Well, here's what you should do to price your home for the marketplace. Number one, you need to know your goal and timelines. How long are you willing to wait for the price? Number one. And number two, what's actually happening in the marketplace? So here's what we do. We look at what is called the absorption rate, or the inventory level. Because price is a function of supply and demand. So you hire our company to get the most demand. So you want to get an agency. You want to get a real estate agency with a marketing plan to get the most exposure for your home. The more marketing dollars they have, the more demand they can get for your home. Professional photography, drone photography, video tours, 3D tours, all the like. Now, price is a function of supply and demand. We talked about demand. So you get the best marketing agency you can. And then you look at the supply, and the supply is going to tell you where to price it. So we call it inventory, the total number of homes on the market divided by how many homes sell per month. So I'll give you an example. 100 homes on the market and 10 homes sell per month is 10 months of inventory. Let me say that again. 100 homes on the market divided by 10 homes sell per month is 10 months of inventory. The lower the inventory level, the higher you can go on your list price, the higher you can ask for your home. So right now, in today's environment, inventory is really low. So there might be 10 homes on the market and 10 homes sell per month. That's 1 month of inventory. 6 months is a balanced market. Anything under 6 months is a seller's market. Anything above 6 months is a buyer's market. So I'm talking to the homeowners right now. If your home has a 1 month of inventory level, so 0 to 2 months of inventory, which is really low, it's a seller's market, you can price your home from 0 to 10%, sometimes 10% higher than the last sale, just like yours. So if you find a comparable sale that sold like yours, home like yours sold for, say, $300, if there's only 1 month of inventory, you might be able to list your home for $330, 10% more. And I've been saying this over and over again, that agents and homeowners are giving their homes away. They're just giving them away because they're pricing their homes based on the past. See, they saw their neighbor's home sold for $300. They priced theirs at $310 when they could have priced it at $330. Well, they didn't know. And what their agent didn't tell them was the inventory level and the absorption rate and why that matters. So if you want to know your absorption rate, your inventory level for your style of home in your neighborhood, which you need to know, reach out to us, reach out to an agent in your, if you're watching this outside of Eastern Washington, North Central Washington, reach out to an agent that understands absorption rates and inventory levels and what that means to your list price. Use it as an interview question. Ask them. I don't only want you to bring me recent sales. I want you to bring me recent inventory levels for my type of home in my area. Because what an agent's going to do is they're going to give you inventory levels for the whole marketplace. Hope this helps. If you have any questions about real estate, reach out to our team. If you have any ideas or questions and you want us to shoot a video, leave a comment or send us a message and we'll shoot a video.